Hello guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. First off, sorry for not uploading frequently. I have been just slammed at work, and then I went home for a weekend, just a lot. And then to make matters even more interesting, I actually had a video that was gonna upload last week, but I have new editing software, and so I'm just trying to learn everything all over. I invested in myself, got a few new things, so I wanna make better content for my channel, and let's just say it's just taking me a moment to just figure everything out. However, let's go ahead and get started. For today's video, we are going to do a comparison. So I did a quick review on this guy here. This is the CoverFX Translucent Powder in Deep. And then the following week, I was like, you know what? Let me order the Laura Mercier, all right? So I've been using the CoverFX, love it, it's great. But then when I saw Laura Mercier, it's like, I really, really want to know what's the difference. If there is a difference, and if one is better than the other. I can say I wore this one yesterday and I was thoroughly impressed. So here's what we're gonna do. We are going to put these both on my face. I'm not going to tell you which side has what. You're gonna follow me to work today. I'm gonna vlog it. I'll let you guys see my face, what's going on. Then at the end of the video, I will tell you which side is which. I'll tell you which one I think looks the best. And then I want you guys to tell me down below in the comments which one you think looks good, all right? So I don't have on any concealers. I'm just going to go ahead and pop on some concealer. I've been using the Tarte Shape Tape concealer here, and I will have a review on this probably within the next 2 weeks or so. And this is just a Real Techniques. It's a contour brush, but it's nice and dense. I feel like it's a little too wide for contouring, so I just like to use it to blend in my concealer. Wanna see my new baby? Oh, this is Rocket. Say hi, Rocket. You're not gonna say hi? Say hi, guys. Oh, no, don't lick me, don't lick me. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, ciao, you gotta go. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. I'm gonna apply the first powder on the right side of my face, your left, and I'm not going to tell you which one this is. Then I'm just gonna take a damp beauty blender. And then with this side that I've already got my powder on, I'm just gonna go ahead and set the rest of my face. I will say that I am loving that these brands are coming out with translucent powders for deeper skin tone. And a lot of people are like, oh, well, if it's got a little color to it, then that means it's not translucent. And it's like, yes, but what you need to keep in mind is that sometimes on, I feel like even on fair skin tones as well, like the translucent powder, it can alter the shade just a little bit and make you look a little bit lighter. So that's why I'm really enjoying this. And then even with the deeper ones, it does have a color to it, but it's definitely not anything like a pressed powder. It literally just sits on your face and it helps to blend everything together and set everything. So I'm here for it. I will say, if you are lighter than me, these might not work for you. It might pop off dark on your skin. It might make your skin a little bit darker. So just keep that in mind. For reference, I always have my foundation shades in the description box. I'll just always reference MAC because everyone's familiar with that. My shade in MAC is NW43, if that helps any of you. All right, next powder. And I flipped over my beauty blender so that way it's not on the same side. I will say this, if you're someone that likes a super, super flaky highlight, then you might not like the translucent powders for that have the color in it, because it will deepen up your highlight under the eye. I don't like that look personally. That's just not my makeup style. So, and I don't mind everything being one color, so to speak. The only time I'll do like a brighter under eye is if I'm going out taking pictures or something like that, but for the most part, for like my everyday wear, I don't do a really, really bright under eye. So that is something else that you might want to take into consideration. Now I'm just going to go ahead and set the rest of my face. Just like in the forehead area. All right, so let me get up close, a little closer. So this is the right side, powder one. This is the left side, powder two. I legit cannot tell a difference. Let me go ahead, put on some bronzer and lip color, and I'll be right back for you guys.
Guys, one last thing I wanted to mention, excuse the mess, I'm in the middle of doing my makeup, but the cover of X Powder, it does have a sifter on it. I just made a mess on accident. I left the sifter open and then I dropped it, and so all the powder kind of flew over on one side, but the cover of X one does have a sifter, so it is less messy unless you leave it open and drop it like me, but you guys probably won't do that. And then the Laura Mercier is just like the other one, no sifter. All right,
so I finished up the rest of my face. I did a very minimal look today. I put on a little bit of bronzer, my Makeup Revolution Rock On World highlight. This is actually on my cheeks and what's on my eyes. And then this lip color, dogs. Sorry guys. Then this lip color actually just came in the mail yesterday. This is Kat Von D Plath, the liquid lipstick. I ordered this from her website. I can't find it on Sephora, so I don't know if maybe it was a limited edition color, but I am loving this look. All right, so this is what we're looking like right now. Right side, one powder, left side, other, even with the rest of my makeup on. I can't tell a difference. So I'm gonna get ready to go to work and I will see you guys in a little bit.
Okay guys, so I just wanted to get a little bit of more natural lighting so you guys can see my face. Here we go. Up close and personal. This is my right side, has one powder, and then this is the left. So I will check in with you again right sometime during work. All right, guys? All right, 1 o'clock, checking in, right side. Still have not done any blotting, and here's the left. Right, left, right, left. Looks the same to me. All right guys, I'm in different lighting. It is 4:30 on the dot, and this is what my face looks like still right now. This is the right side, this is the left side. I have not blotted all day long. Let me get you all up in my situation so you can see what's going on. I'm going to go ahead and blot. More than anything, my nose is super, super oily, but I think I put too much highlight on. So I'm just gonna go ahead and blot really quick. Okay, and I still can't tell a difference. Again, one powder's on my right side, one's on the left. Everything looks the same. All right, so I will see you guys when I get back.
All right, guys, I am home from work, had a long day. It's 7 o'clock, came home, put on my pajamas, wiped off my lipstick, and I was like, oh crap, I have to do my last check-in and final thoughts. So, time for the big reveal. This side is with the Laura Mercier, and this side is with the Cover FX, both shades and deep. Okay, so here are my thoughts. I love, 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 love the Laura Mercier. So I feel like as far as on the face, you cannot tell much of a difference. They both go on the same. The shade is basically the same thing. They're both very similar in shade. I will say I feel like the Laura Mercier is just a little bit more finely milled, and I felt like it did keep me a little bit more matte, but like I said, I am oily, and no matter what, my oil will push through. It always comes through no matter what. So as far, as far as which one I think you should get, they are both the same thing, practically. It does not matter. So if you're more of a Cover FX fan, or if you've already been using the Laura Mercier, you're just gonna stick with that. But as far as I'm concerned, you could use either one and you will be good to go. Also, keep in mind a few other things that I said. If you're someone that likes a flaky highlight, you might not like this because it might tone down your bright under eye. Also, if you are lighter than me, this might pop off a little too deep on your skin tone. So just make sure you keep those things in mind, all right guys? So that is going to wrap up this video. I'm about to go sit on the sofa and watch some TV and relax, and I will see you guys in my next video.